Let's meet the fan stars in and beyond our galaxy. Some are very far, but still bright enough to see. Let's meet your favorite stars. There are many different kinds. They will blow your mind. Let's meet your favorite stars. We'll travel very far out through our universe. I wonder who we'll meet first. Will we meet a sub-dwarf star less luminous than main sequence stars? Will we meet a brown dwarf star, the missing link between planets and stars? Will we meet a HAeBe star, three main sequence stars with circumstellar disk AR? Will we meet the farthest known supergiant? I really love science.
A cool red sub-dwarf, I'm Kapteyn Star. My luminosity is low in the constellation Pitor, the nearest star within the galactic halo. I have at least two planets orbiting me, including a super Earth planet. Five times more massive than Earth, it could support alien life on it.
We're Luhman 16, a binary brown dwarf star, only 6.5 light years away in the constellation Vela we are. With masses between gas giant planets and small stars, we can't fuse hydrogen, but we do emit light and heat from radiation within. I'm HV100546, a Herbig AEBE star. This means I'm very young and my fusing of hydrogen to helium has yet to start. HAeBe stars are surrounded by circumstellar disks of debris where new exoplanets are being born, like HD100546B.
A super giant from Orion, the sword of the giants. My name is Saiph. My strong stellar winds are causing me to lose a lot of mass at a fast pace. I'm really hot and I spin really fast, so I expend a lot of energy. I'll eventually expand into a red giant and supernova spectacularly.
I'm Naos from the constellation Puppus, a very rare O-type star, a blue supergiant, one of the bluest and most luminous stars there are. I'm extremely hot, approximately 42,000 degrees Kelvin, and I'm the closest O-type star to your sun.
I'm Gacrux, a binary star from the Crux constellation, not only the top star, but the only red star in the Southern Cross asterism. The Southern Cross is a popular Earth symbol, so I'm featured on lots of flags you'll see, and I'm the closest red giant star to Earth. Maybe someday you'll visit me.
I'm Earendel, the morning star, a blue giant from the constellation Cetus, the farthest known star yet discovered even further away than Icarus. 28 billion light years away, they used gravitational lensing to find me. A galaxy cluster between us acted as a magnifying lens, you see.
I'm Regulus, the heart of the lion in the Leo constellation. I'm also one of three stars in the Spring Triangle asterism. I rotate once every 16 hours, so I'm egg-shaped from spinning so fast. And surprise, I'm a quadruple star. Four stars in one, we're having a blast.
Stars in and beyond our galaxy. Some are very far, but still bright enough to see. Let's meet your favorite stars. There are many different kinds. They will blow your mind. Let's meet your favorite stars. We'll travel very far out through our universe. I wonder who we'll meet first. Will we meet a six-fold star, three pairs of orbiting binary stars? Will we meet the loneliest star, shining bright in the dark where no other stars are? Will we meet an alien megastructure star behaving unpredictably? How bizarre! Will we meet a light-echoing supergiant? I really love science.
I'm Castor of the Gemini twins. I'm one of the heads of them. Six stars in one, three pairs of binary stars make up my system. All six of my stars are gravitationally bound and dance around each other. Five separate but tight orbits we have with our sisters and brothers.
I'm Fomalhaut, the loneliest star, a bright light in the dark sky. But I'm a triple star, so at least I have my two companions nearby. There could be exoplanets hiding in my rings of gas, dust, and debris, though scientists now think my zombie exoplanet was just a dust cloud near me.
Tabby star, I'm a complete mystery. I'm confusing astronomers with my unusual fluctuations in brightness, you see. Am I a part of an extraterrestrial megastructure? That's one way it could be explained. Other theories are colliding comets, weird dust clouds. Whatever it is, it's strange.
E838, Monocerotis, an amazing sight to see. My outer layers had a rapid expansion eruption, and I became huge suddenly. This created a light echo, an expanding halo of light around me, illuminating and revealing beautiful nebulae.
We've only scratched the surface. There are billions of stars, you see. But now we've met a few and understand their diversity. Let's keep on exploring our wondrous universe. Keep discovering new stars. Which star will you meet first?
Still haven't seen your favorite star yet? Don't worry. There are billions of stars to meet, and we need your help. Can you find an incredibly amazing star for us to meet? We're looking for the most unique and mysterious stars that we haven't met yet in Meet the Stars Parts 1 through 6. Send your star votes to info@naworldmusic.net. We'll pick the 12 most fascinating stars for Meet the Stars Part 7, coming in 2024. Stay tuned for more fun videos. Thanks for watching!